In this video, I want to show you how to do Landsat images atmospheric correction using semi-automatic classification plugin in QGIS. So to do that, let me show you my folder. In this folder, I have the Landsat images. Let me open it. Here I have all the bands for Landsat 8 for year 2023. So to do the atmospheric correction, let me go back a step. Open your QGIS. Then the first thing you need to do is to install the semi-automatic classification plugin. In the previous video, I've shown you how to install it, but if you have not watched that video, you can quickly watch it, or let me just show you. Just click on plugin and click on manage and install plugin. So here, search for semi-automatic plugin, and this is it. So once you click on it, you will see install here. Because I've already installed it, that's why it's showing me reinstall. So if you have not installed it, just install it. After installing it, you should be able to see the menu here. To do the atmospheric correction for Landsat image, come to this very semi-automatic classification plugin. Click on it and come to pre-processing. Then choose Landsat. So it will open this table for you, and here you need to come to the directory containing the Landsat image. That is this folder I shown you the other time, which contains the Landsat image. So to do that, click here and navigate to your folder and select the folder containing your Landsat image. This is it. Then click on select. So it will capture that directory of the folder. Then if the MTL file is not present in the folder you selected, then you have to specify the folder where the MTL file is. This is what I mean. If I go back to my folder and open this folder containing my Landsat image, if I scroll down, you can see apart from bands and other supporting file, there is a particular file called MTL that ended with MTL. If your own file called MTL is not in this folder, you have to specify. But if it is in this folder, you don't need to specify again. Let's go back. Then here, make sure you check apply DOS atmospheric correction. That's what you want to do. So you will check it. Then also brightness temperature in Celsius. So also select it or check it. So if you come to this very metadata, you can see all your file here, all the file in that folder relating to the Landsat image is already here. You can cross check them here. So after you have chosen all these, and also if you want to perform pan sharpening of that Landsat image, you can also choose this, but I'm not interested in that. So I only want to do atmospheric correction, and also I want to do brightness temperature in Celsius. So after that, click here to run. And this time around, when you click to run, it will ask you to specify your output folder. So let's go a step. You can create a new folder here. Just right click and come to new. Then click on folder. So let's create a folder and call it results. So then click on that result to select it and click on select folder. So when you do that, you can see it goes blind. It means the process is ongoing background. You can bring this one down to see the process. You can see the process is going on. So the atmospheric correction is running background. And one good thing about it is that after it is done, all the bands will be added to the QGIS. So as it is running, you can be doing other things else, because it actually takes several minutes to run. And the reason why it takes several minutes is because it's run all the processes for each band. So for example, if you have about 12 bands in that very Landsat image, so it's run all the processes for each of the band. The process is already at band 6, so we still have a long way to go. So this is actually how it takes time. is now at band 8. So that is how it will run the process for all the bands in the folder. Yes, it is done. So we can now close this. Yes, and immediately it finishes it, it added it to the QGIS interface. And you can see all the bands here. If I expand it, you can see everything here from band 1 to band 11. So this is how to do atmospheric correction on Landsat image in QGIS using semi-automatic classification plugin. So if you have any question or any challenge when you are practicing, let us know in the comment section. Thank you for watching.